The initial revolution in Russia, what's called the Communist Revolution in October 1917, in line with Marx, they begin a war on religion. They begin shutting down churches, making it illegal to talk about God in public. They start killing ministers, they start killing pastors, they start killing priests. This was key for communism because Lenin and later Stalin understood you had to replace something with something. You can't replace something with nothing. And what they wanted to replace the church with was the state.
They actually did infiltrate our institutions. Now it's become cliche to joke about these lunatic right-wing senators who are complaining about fictional communists in the government. We know there were communists in the government. I can name them for you. We have Alger Hiss, who is probably the most famous of them.
Whitaker Chambers talks about that part of their directive as communists was to be unfaithful to their wives, to have no allegiance to any particular partner.
Well, famously, I mean, in Stalinist Russia, one of the heroes of the Republic, I mean, a person who was basically marched in every major parade, was a 13-year-old boy who had turned in his father for treason, right? He made some sort of joke about Stalin at home, and the 13-year-old boy immediately went to the authorities, they executed the father, and the kid was a national hero. Destroying the family unit is a key to removing all other sources of authority except for the great authority that is the government.
When you destroy the family, you can destroy the whole culture. And once that foundation is gone, then you can come in and take over with a totalitarian government.
The church and religion is a threat when the state claims to be God.
You don't want any higher power than the state.
Right. And you don't want your people growing up believing in that because they may challenge the state.
Just because you get rid of one religion doesn't mean you get rid of all religion. We might get rid of Christianity as the religion that we worship, but there will be a new religion that replaces it. And unfortunately, today we're seeing that. That's the religion of secular liberalism.